Remyelination is a process where myelin's put back on nerves. And in MS, myelin comes off nerves, the process of demyelination. And it's good to think of nerves like wires and the myelin like the insulating layer, the plastic insulation around wires. And you need that plastic insulation to allow nerves to conduct electricity well. It falls off in MS, and what we think is if we can put it back on in the process of remyelination, then that will help the nerves to conduct electricity as well as they did before, hopefully. But actually, the other thing we know is that the myelin sheath actually feeds the underlying nerve, and so it also protects that nerve from dying in the long term. So we think it's all good. There's good evidence that it is possible to remyelinate nerves. There's good evidence that we actually do that anyway as human beings. We can remyelinate our nerves. It's easier to do when you're young than when you're old, like repairing anything. So we do think it happens, but we know that in multiple sclerosis, it's never sufficient. It's always a bit inefficient. It was not quite complete. And that gets worse as you get older. So what we're trying to do is find ways to make remyelination more efficient, work better, and perhaps quicker so that we can protect these nerves and keep them alive. Predicting time to when we get treatments is always really difficult, and it's never good to be pinned down on timing. But you know, we know that we can improve remyelination in animal models and in cell-based models, so we can do it. But actually trying to get that into something that makes a difference to people is much more difficult. And that's partly because we don't really know who to treat. It's partly because we don't know how long to treat for. It's actually really difficult to measure remyelination. And so we need better ways of doing that, so that we can see that whether the drugs that we test in the lab actually work in people. But all that being said, I think we will have good treatments for MS in the next 5 to 10 years in the later phases. So these are the neuroprotective ones that stop nerves dying, which are very separate from the really good drugs that we have already for the early phases of MS, which simply stop relapses and encourage remission. So I think it's very sensible to think of drugs for MS into two camps, the ones that we're actually really good at, which is the disease-modifying therapies that we have for relapsing remitting MS, which has been a major success. And then what we need to do next is improve the protection of nerves, so sort of anti-neurodegeneration drugs. And it's that which is really difficult. And it's not just MS it's difficult in Alzheimer's disease, in motor neuron disease, in Parkinson's disease. So MS is in the same camp. And if we can help neurodegeneration in one, we can probably help it in all of these. So that will be a huge step forward. And I'd be really disappointed if that isn't in place in the next 10 years. I think it's really key to work together with other people working in diseases which we can group together as neurodegenerative diseases. So in all of these diseases, such as Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease, motor neuron disease, the bottom line is that you lose nerves. And we know we do that in MS as well. And so working together to try and keep nerves alive is going to be really helpful for all of these diseases. So I think it's absolutely key. And people are really trying hard now to get together and to share ideas which span the different diseases, because although the causes of these diseases are different, the actual problem at the bottom is the same. So I think we can do it together. So the Octopus Trial is the MS Society UK's platform trial, which is aiming over the next 10 years to get good drugs that work for neurodegeneration in MS. So this is what we call progressive MS, when people steadily get worse over time, rather than having the relapsing and remissions of early phase MS. And so what we're trying to do is take a very different approach from the early phase drugs, which are all working against T and B cells in the immune system. We're trying to think about ways to protect nerves. So these drugs have to get into the brain, which of course relapsing remitting ones don't have to. They have to get into the brain and they have to have effects against the processes that make nerves die. So the Octopus trial is that, and it's rather a special trial. And it's called Octopus because it's got several arms or legs. And it's only got three. This octopus only has three arms at the moment. But the arms are the placebo, so the sugar pill, which is the best practice arm. And then it's got two other arms. At the moment, those are a drug called lipoic acid and another one called metformin. And they will be compared. People won't know which one they're getting, but they'll be compared with each other. And then at 2 years, we'll decide, well, do they look like they're working? If it works, it becomes the best practice arm. If it doesn't work, it falls out of the equation. And then a new arm will come in, new drugs will come in. And then that will carry on over time with different checkpoints. And it's called a multi-arm, multi-stage trial. And it was incredibly successful at getting prostate cancer drugs into normal clinical use. So we're sort of coming up to thinking about the second year stage now. So we're thinking about new arms to go in. But this is the good thing about it is, like, the infrastructure for doing the trials is there. We don't have to dissemble it and reassemble it. Each time we want to do a trial, it's there. We just add things in. It's throughout the UK. And in fact, also Australia has now got a version of this, which rather amusingly is called Platypus rather than Octopus, which I love. But they also trying to do it because the more people we can get, the more likely we are to see a signal. And then most research is incremental. So we do a bit better and then we have to build on that and do a bit better and then a bit better. And so, you know, I think we'd be looking for a small signal, which then we can grow over the next sort of 8 to 10 years. So I think it's exciting. So if people are interested in that, if they go to the MS Register website and register your interest, then you end up getting newsletters, which keeps you up to date, which is, you know, half of the battle is knowing what's going on.